Hello students and welcome back. I hope you are healthy and fit. Doing your work, assignment, task and obey the order of your elders. Keep the same thing in your mind. I am also doing something good for you. As we know about that, in this 21st century, we are going to deal with a lot of problems. But there is a lot of solution also. And the important thing is that 21st century is science and technology. So with the help of science and technology, we are going to promote the system of videos and communication with you, not direct, but in the way of indirect way. As we know about that, in previous videos we are dealing with the class 5, unit number 5, lesson number 2, Rip Van Winkle, which is going to deal about the complete explanation. As we know about that, after the explanation, we want to recall our memory, recall our points, and recall about our understanding or checking our understanding. On the point of view that, we are now going to complete the exercise about this Rip Van Winkle. Because exercise is a parameter, a evidence, a thing which is proof that how much you understood the lesson, how much you understood the previous knowledge or previous explanation. That is a very important thing there. If you, every time you are completing such things or dealing with such things or reading part, writing part, listening part, or even though listening or watching the things, but end of that, if you want to evaluate, you want to check, you want to recall, you want to know how much you understood, that is the very best thing there. Whatever the exercise given, it should be solved. It will show that how much you understood. Okay, so you people know very well that today in this video we are going to explain or complete the exercise of Rip Van Winkle. So I request all of you, please open the page number 87. Whatever things are in the textbook, complete with the pencil, objectives, fill in the blanks, true or false, whatever things there. Or in such cases, something we need to solve or write something explanation. For that, you need the notebook. So keep the notebook, pen, pencil, textbook, everything what is necessary, and complete or go for our lesson. Fine? Okay? So open the textbook, page number 87. Ready with the pencil. See, the first question, circle the correct meaning of the given words. You may need to use the dictionary. See, even NCERT or the CBC also use some different techniques to know the word meaning. If you go through the previous lessons, what you find? You find that these are word and meaning already given. Your duty is there to understand or learn the new meaning. But here, what happened? The word is already given and asking to you find out the correct meaning. Means it is an initiative taken by the teacher or the students find out such type of meaning. Okay? First, idle away means wastage, constant, steady. See, yeah, already samples are there. Companion, partner, release. To understand, descend, to move down, barrel, a wooden container, contains the ingredients, okay? So these are the few new words which is based on textbook. Even during the explanation, I am already given you the new words. So my request, along with these new words or exercise, you can write that words which is explained during the video and note down in your notebooks. Fine? So this is the first question. Now, second question. Question number 2. Match the word in the box with the meanings. You may take the help of the dictionary. See, near the lower part of the mountain. See, actually this is the actual meaning or verb sentence. Now what happened? Convert a complete sentence into one word. So this is a sentence converted into one word. What is the particular word about this complete sentence? Near the lower part of a mountain, it says foothills. Add on, what do you say? Foothills. There are two words, foot and then hills. So lower part of the mountain is called foothills. Second, with grey hair. With grey hair, we find out the quality of old person. That short old person is then to whom our ring meant. So grizzled, grizzled, grizzled. To rub gently, stroked, stroked, stroked. To be very surprised, astonished, astonished, means to be very surprised, seeing that all happens in the mind that old person. Known to you is familiar. I am familiar with you, you are familiar with me. After a long time, or sorry, from 3 or 4 months, we are connected with this video. So what happened? You are familiar with me, it means known to you. Okay, write down in this book with the help of pencil. Don't mistake the spellings. Now next, see whether the following sentences are true or false. See what happened. Rip was kind to children. True or false? True. That is a true. Rip was hard working man. Is it correct? Yes or no? Yes. False. No. It is a false. The short old man on the mountain was his constant companion. Now we know about that. His constant companion is dog. So third one is false. Rip helped the old man on the mountain because he wanted to have a drink from the barrel. Is it? No. Actually, he don't have any intention. That our rib by nature is helping kind person. So that's why he wanted help. Seeing that the old person is carrying the barrel, for that purpose he went for the help. So fourth one also false. Rib was away from 20 years because he was asleep on the mountain. Rib was away from the 20 years because he was asleep on the mountain. Fifth one is a false. Actually, you are confused. It is silly. But he went very well. What he was, because he was sleep on the mountains. Actually, he don't know about that. After drinking, it was happening with him. Okay. The drink from the barrel made him fall asleep for 20 years. Correct. The reason behind that, which drink he, what type of liquids given or offered by that old person, that reason that he went for the asleep. Nobody recognized him when he come back because he had reached the wrong village. That's it. He reached the wrong village. It's a false. Don't say it's a wrong village. It's a false. Nobody recognized him when he come back because he had reached the wrong village. Actually, he reach a proper way, but his attire, his look, his body language, his physical appearance totally changed. See now, you just guessed. After 20 years, if you have visited somewhere, a place where the people know your childhood face, and after 20 years, age of near one old age, how is possible? That thing is here, fine. From the page number 88. Come to the following sentences. Number one, Reap village was situated where? At the foothills of Likkad Skill. If somebody will write at the foothills, but already that person giving the noun, name, Likkad Skill. So write down that one. The children of the village loved him because he played with them. Dash was his constant companion. Boo, the dog. Correct. And also write their name. Name, Ulf. The villagers stared at him because Dash, no one knew him. Right? No one knew because completely physical appearance changed. The old man who recognized him was his neighbor. His neighbor. So what happened? From this we can guess that Reap went or reached the correct village. Because the old man who recognized Reap was his old neighbor. And so its statement shows that our Reap reached at the or at that same place or same village. Come and reach right down. Now see, work in a group of four, what were the strange things about the men on the mountain? Actually, it's actually which about, we say, it's about, we say, it is a part of the class activity. Where all students are there and they will communicate with them and come to the things. A group activity, a peer group activity, a social behavior, social connectivity is there. But here, are not possible for this condition. So I request you, if you have brothers, sisters, okay, other family members, read the story, explain the story, talk to the story, and after that, with the help of your companion, who are there, the brother, sister, grandmother, grandfather, uncle, auntie, who are there with your family, sit with them and solve it. So it will be showing that understanding or combined effort or connectivity or attachment with your family partners or family members. See here. Going group, what were the strange things about the men on the mountains? It's about the men, okay? M-E-N, men, not M-A-N. It's about the M-E-N men on the mountain. They all were dressed in the same way first. They all were dressed in the same way. You got in the photo? We see this photo? Same. Second, they had beard of various shapes and colors. What they have? They have different type of beards, various shapes and colors. White, black, or you know, grizzled, brown. They were serious even while playing a game. What happened? If you know how we are playing the game, so it will enter the fun. We love it. We show our interest and fun and happiness. But here, they are playing the 9 balls of the game. So they are playing the game but showing their seriousness. They are very serious. They were very short headed. Right? They were very short headed. So these are a few or four things which we know about the men on the mountains based on your test book. Next. What kind of a man was Reap Van Winkle? He was very lazy. He liked to play with children. Yes, we know we are very lazy and he liked to play with children. He was a good-natured fellow. Okay? Some more point is there. So just discuss, talk, read once, twice, or thrice the lesson or the story and get some more information. These are basic information, basic things that we know about that Reap. Lazy, involved with the children activity or playing with children, and good nature. How? Ready to help anyone. who are in front of you, anybody who need to help, be ready to do the best of it. Okay, on giving the help. Here, next. Vocabulary reading. Pick out the names of the games mentioned in this story. What are the games they mentioned? So this game we will just find out. So if this is my answer, but whenever you find this type of word underlined, what it shows? It shows that these different games which is introduced or talked or discussed in this lesson. What? Flying kites. We read taught the children how to fly the kites. Second, shooting the marbles, same thing. Our Reed is playing with children. What game? Flying kites and shooting the marble. Third one, nine pins. Which we know about that? This game we know about that. The old man in the mountain. That game. So, children and Reed, these are two blocks with the children and Reed. And this one, nine pins are about the old person. About that old person they are playing. Okay, and they are so very serious.
Now you came, you are going.
Now, sometimes we join the two words to make a describing word. For example, Rip was good-natured man. Everybody liked him. Here are some more describing words. Use them to complete the given picture. See, some we are no other words. Example, Rip was good-natured. Along with two words, good and nature. Everybody. Then these are some words which are, you know, long, sleeved, high-heeled, well-dressed, open-mouthed, sweet-looking, odd-looking, or part-time. Now see what we do. See here. Mrs. Das had a part-time job. See, we use that word. What are the words I've given up? We use part and time. We combine that word and using a full, a complete meaning. So, see, Mrs. Das had a part-time job in clothes shop. What is the meaning? Second, yesterday an old-looking woman walked into the shop. Old-looking. She was wearing high-heeled shoes. And from here, a sweet-looking dog was with her. See, how these two different words combinedly said, combinedly attached, combinedly merged and introduce a new meaning, and that also support your sentence. Sweet looking dog was with her. I want a long sleeved shirt for my dog. Please, she said, for your dog, ask Mrs. Das. Open mouth in surprise. Yes, replied the man. I want him to be a well-dressed for my next party. So these are the combined word which is having two different adjective, noun, okay, adverb, and combine it together and introduce a new meaning. When you are going to higher classes or higher studies, so you will find this type of words. Prefix, suffix, okay, root word, connective word, and what they introduce that things. So it is just for your example, how if you merge two words, combine the two words, so how they get them different meaning and how you can use in our sentence. Got it? So today in this video, we'll stop here, and the remaining exercise we're going to learn in the next video. Till then, have a nice day.